I think I was wrong about that I missed the Bitcoin Cash bottom. I was following Dope Forever there in her analysis, but I think she was not right. She was right in that there was massive volume for Bitcoin Cash on the rebound when it went up from $75 to $220. There was indeed massive volume, more volume than ever before, even during the bull market. But there was no volume when it went down to $75 from straight from 600. But the last it broke 400, then it went in one straight line to 75, but slowly, every day a little bit more. And if you look at the volume when it went down from say $200 to $75, the volume was very, very low. The same as with Bitcoin, BTC, the volume was also very low. That's why many people called that was not the bottom when it went to $3,000 or $3,100 or $3,200. That was not the bottom. But the same is valid for Bitcoin Cash. The volume was very, very low, and so. And that's what counts. It does the volume on the rebound does not count. What counts is the volume on the crash, and especially at the bottom. Is there lots of volume there? And that was not the case for Bitcoin Cash. And it was there for 3 days, around $80, and the bottom was $75 for 1 day. But it was for 3 days that it was below $80, and that's also very weird for a bottom to be there for 3 days. Well, I just took a short look at the bottom of Bitcoin in 2015, January, and it bottomed then from basically went from $300 to $160. $ but that happened in one day, and it was only a couple of hours. It was at 160. It went straight up back to 220, and then the day after it went back to $180, and then in the same day it went back to $200. So it was only for a couple of hours that the absolute bottom of $155 to be exact was hit, and so. It looks very different, and so I think therefore that even for Bitcoin Cash it is not likely that we have seen the bottom, because of the way the bottom was formed, the volume that was not there, it took too long to be at that price. But also, in addition, of course, is that, well, for the whole crypto market, the timing is off. And so it's most likely to see a bottom for Bitcoin later in this year, and to be have a bottom around Kevin Svensson estimates 2,500. And also, thank you so much, Kevin, for pointing it out. I was probably wrong about the Bitcoin Cash bottom. That really helps me a lot. And 2,500 the estimates, but he leaves possibilities open to go down to $1,200, and I think that might be possible. See my previous videos about why, especially we have hit a serious undervaluation, one with a short video. I think that can show very well that yes, a total market cap of $60 billion is possible to be the low. And yeah, if you do your calculations, then yeah, you're below $2,000 for Bitcoin. So 1,800 it could be, 1,200 it could be. But that means that let's stay modest here, and let's say it's half of what we saw. We saw $3,100. Let's say the actual bottom is half of that, $1,600. Well, what does that mean for Bitcoin Cash? Well, at that point, Bitcoin Cash was at $75. Will it also be cut by two? Well, that would be $35, $40, and that's where I put my new bottom target for Bitcoin Cash at $40. But realistically, it will be a little lower, because when Bitcoin halves, smaller coins do much more than half. Just halving, they do a cut by three or four. So that would mean for Bitcoin Cash not 40, but $30 and even $20 is possible. And so that's where I set my new orders, around 40. And then some people are asking, but why are you trying to catch the bottom? It's a fool's job, and you can never guess that. Some people even say it's not possible to estimate these things. It's not possible to estimate how long a bear market will last. That's all not true. Huh? You can study past patterns and extrapolate. And of course, it's an educated guess, but it is educated, and it's better than not guessing. And also averaging in, I think, is just overvalued. Averaging in, if you look at the studies, there are plenty of studies around what's the best investment strategy, averaging in or buying in one lump sum. It's actually buying in one lump sum, it's not averaging in. And if you can combine that with trying to estimate the market more correctly and buy with that one lump sum when there is a serious correction, then you're gonna do much better than the average investor. And that's what I share with people on my channel. That's why I said don't buy for the whole year of 2018. And especially for Bitcoin Cash, when it was bottoming at 400 for a long time, I said no, because I tried to estimate the bottom and I thought it would be $200. I was wrong with that. I bought a big lump sum at $250, but that was overall, even though I was wrong about the bottom, a much better move than the typical investor trying to really start buying way too soon. Many people started buying Bitcoin Cash already at $800. It came from 4,000. So yeah, you start buying below 1,000, it does look not that bad of a deal. But buying at 800, buying at 600, even buying at 500 and 400, that was all, of course, not such a great move if you can buy it today at 150. So I do think that trying to time the market makes a lot of financial sense, and that's what I do here, and that's why try to do this wrong sometimes and admit my mistakes as quickly as possible and set my new buy orders lower or higher. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks so much for watching.